Thank you. and gentlemen, please welcome acoustic disc recording artist, the Dave Brisman Quintet. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much. I'd like to send that one out to all the elephants. And I don't know if they have dogs in this zoo or not, but sound like they do. Thank you all for coming out. We're going to try and catch you up with what's been happening in the world of dog music as we know it. And we'll start with the title tune from our latest album, No Home Should Be Without One. We've got a few here we can part with. This is called Dog Wood. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. That was also on our latest CD. That's called Dogmatism. I'd like to introduce the members of the quintet so that you know who you're cheering for here. They're all good California boys, California stock. I find them down there and bring them, import them into other areas. Starting out with the man on the bass, who's been the dog bass man for almost a decade now. He's getting tired of taking that thing around. How many of you all like the acoustic upright bass? Yeah. You think he should get an electric bass? Well, all right, I want you to remember his name now. That's Jim Kerwin on the bass. Now, a lot of guys play the bass, but very few play the case. Well, this next young man does. He plays the fiddle, and he plays the fiddle case as well. The first man I know to play the fiddle case in Carnegie Hall. A man of many talents from Davis, California, Joe Bob Craven.
Hey, Joe Bob!
Hey. Next fellow over here plays a very unique stringed instrument. It's called a flute. I don't know how many of y'all have heard of a flute. It just consists of one very large hollowed out string that you blow into. Very novel idea. And he does it just about better than anybody I've ever heard. The first flute man to ever play dog music, and probably be the last. Well, this is the whole extent of dog flute right here. From Richmond, California, Matthew Eckel. Don't give him too much. Don't applaud too much for him. He'll get a swelled head, you know. No, that's you just go to town. This next fellow in line, he is carrying on in the tradition of Tony Rice and Mark O'Connor, Mike Marshall, and several others who have played this instrument, which used to be the most popular instrument in America until a couple of weeks ago was finally overtaken by the mandolin. That's a guitar, and we like to have one in the group anyway. He also from Davis, California, Mr. Rick Montgomery. I'd like to play a piece that I wrote for my good friend and one of the great musicians of any time, the great Stefan Grappelli. And I had the privilege of recording this with Stefan about 12 years ago on an album called Dog Jazz, which is now out of print. So we recorded a new version of it, and we'd like to play it for you right now. It's going to feature Joe and Rick doing a little hot club tribute. This is called Steppin' with Stefan. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. How many of y'all like bluegrass music? Well, this isn't really bluegrass, this is more like zoograss. This comes from an album that I made a couple of years ago with the man that gave me my first job in bluegrass, a man named Red Allen, who I don't know if you've heard of him, but made a lot of great records in the 50s, and he gave me a job in 1966, and I produced one of his early records, or a few of his early records, and was able to make an album 2 years ago, or 3 years ago, called The Bluegrass Reunion with Red, Herb Peterson, Jim Buchanan, Jim Kerwin, and special guest Jerry Garcia. You've heard of Jerry. And sadly, Red passed away earlier this year, so this was actually his last recording. But I wrote a tune on there for him, and I dedicated it to him, and named it after his birthplace, a place called Pigeon Roost, Kentucky. So we'd like to play this little ditty called Pigeon Roost. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. We're going to play one more for you, then we're going to take a little break. And then we're going to come back and play a whole bunch more. How's that? So don't get anywhere, go anywhere too far away. Like I mentioned, we do have CDs and cassettes here. If you would like one, we got about 8 different ones of ours and other things. I've got my own CD label called Acoustic Disc. It's all acoustic music. So check it out. And here's one from our first release on that label, a record called Dog 90. It's already out of date. But you know how music is. It only lasts for about 6 weeks, the life of any kind of music. After that, it's over.
Look at Beethoven,
man. Anyhow, this is called Little Samba. so much. How are you? How would you like to go to Brazil for a few minutes now? All right, we're going to play some music. It was written by the greatest mandolin player from Brazil, who also is a great composer, and he started a whole style of music called choro music. And his name is Jacob do Bandolim. He died in 1969, but he made some great records, and I'm proud to say that I released the first recordings of his in the United States about a year ago. And if you like this, you'll really like the original version, but this is one of his pieces that we also recorded in our latest CD, and it's called Asanhado. Thank you. We'd like to do a piece that was written by the great Django Reinhardt, Bolero de Django. Thank you so much. You know, this is the part of the show where I usually allow Professor Joseph Craven of the Jazz Institute of America speak. But we have a limited time here because, you know, the animals have to go to sleep. But I would like to call Professor Craven up here, up to the podium. He is a bona fide professor of jazz, but get your jazz wardrobe with you. You got that with you? All right. He is going to only speak through rhythm. We're going to have to do an abrupt version of this, but this is, I wrote and I dedicated it to this guy, Jazzin' with Joe Bob. Thank you. Thank you.
The monkeys are
Thank you so much. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. Hey, we'll be glad to sign these CDs if you want to come over and get one. And look for a new album, Jerry Garcia and myself. It's called Not For Kids Only. You can sort of tell what it's for or who it's for, but not entirely. Well, thank you very much. We hope we can come back here again. And here's the number entitled The Dog's Rag.